name is Agustina Vergara Cid, and I'm a junior fellow at the Enron Institute. And the quote I chose is, anyone who fights for the future lives in it today. And that quote is from the introduction to The Romantic Manifesto, one of Rand's books. And in that essay, Ayn Rand was writing about the possibility of a revival of Romantic art to replace the terrible state of contemporary art at the time. And the longer quote, of which this smaller quote is part, says, "Will we see an aesthetic renaissance in our time? I do not know. What I do know is this, anyone who fights for the future lives in it today." For me, the way I see it and how I interpret this quote, like, Rand was making romantic art in her own fiction, and as she was doing it, she was fighting for romantic art and the values that she could transmit through it. And to me, the part "lives in it today" means living one's own values, no matter what else is around you, and no matter if there's a lot of irrationality around you. And I think that is true of any values that you may pursue, not just fiction writing, which is what Rand was specifically referring to in that quote. And this quote, you know, doesn't mean that the values that you pursue will necessarily be widespread in the future. But what it does mean is that you're living now, every day, with the values that you want to see dominate in the future, right? So basically, for me, what this quote is saying and why I find it so powerful is that the act of fighting for certain values in the future puts you in the position of experiencing the feeling of those values today. And for me, I've been trying to do that ever since I started studying objectivism, and increasingly as I learn more about the philosophy. And that quote really stuck with me when I first read it. And then I started paying more attention to how I could live my values every day, and what I needed to do to make the world around me the image of the world that I wanted to see, you know, more broadly and more generally. And I started noticing that Ayn Rand was right. What else is new? But, you know, fighting for my values made me live them today as I was fighting for them. It was like a little preview of the future that I was fighting for. It wasn't like a preview, but a very real one, because I was actually living it. And I was able to have my, you know, my own little pocket of rationality around me in a world that was, in a context in society in which I used to live in, that it was very much irrational, you know, but I had that little pocket of rationality with me, you know, with my loved ones, at work, at school, and as I conducted myself according to these principles and actually fought for them. And so I started fighting for them even more and making very conscious efforts to live by the principles of objectivism and to spread them as much as I could. And it turns out that by following that advice, that you know, the general advice that's contained in the quote, I was able to actually achieve a lot of great things and shape the world around me in a way that was more consistent with my values. One of the main things, and this is not because just of the quote, it's more like I've achieved many things because of the objectivist philosophy in general, but for me, things like moving to America or working at an organization whose mission is to spread these values is, you know, living the future today to me.